Welcome, this is Dr. G, and in this video, we will be talking about vitamin B2, riboflavin. We'll cover its structure, as well as its common symptoms and deficiencies. However, we're going to focus on the two active metabolites of riboflavin and what type of reactions they take part in our bodies. You got this. Let's go. Come on. Starting off with the structure, here you can see this is the structure of riboflavin. Like other vitamin Bs, riboflavin is found in a wide variety of foods, and there's also supplements you can take as well if you need. Once riboflavin is absorbed into our body, it can get metabolized into flavin mononucleotide, or FMN, which then can get further metabolized into flavin adenine dinucleotide, or FAD. Let's first start with flavin mononucleotide, or FMN. It is one of the two active metabolites of riboflavin. Our body can convert it from riboflavin through the enzyme riboflavin kinase. And it's actually the main flavin molecule that we can find in our cells and our bodies. Now, although NAD is by far the more common electron acceptor because it's found in more metabolic pathways, flavin mononucleotide is actually the stronger oxidizing agent, making it a better electron acceptor. It can also accept one or two electrons, making it very versatile. If it were to accept one electron, it becomes a free radical, which we call semiquinone, known as FMNH with a little dot. The dot represents the free radical state. If it were to accept two electrons, then it becomes FMNH2. It acts as a coenzyme for many enzymes collectively known as oxidoreductases. These enzymes participate in redox reactions, and we'll touch on them a bit later. For now, just remember that any enzyme that requires a flavin molecule, not necessarily FMN, there's other molecules in our bodies that are made up of flavin as well. Any enzymes that requires flavin molecules are known as flavoproteins. Next is flavin adenine dinucleotide, or FAD. It is the second active metabolite of riboflavin, and we can convert it from FMN through the enzyme FAD synthase. Like FMN, it can also accept either one or two electrons, making it quite versatile as well. If it were to accept one electron, it turns into a radical, just like FMN, and we call it semiquinone as well. If it were to accept two electrons, it becomes FADH2. Just like FMN, FAD is also a coenzyme for many oxidoreductase enzymes. What are oxidoreductases? It's a group of six enzymes that catalyze redox reactions. Some of them are pretty obvious based on their names. An oxidase catalyzes an oxidation of its substrate. A reductase will reduce its substrate. But what about dehydrogenase? It's actually the most important of the six because you'll see it the most. A dehydrogenase will oxidize the substrate by breaking off a hydrogen. So when you see enzymes with the names of dehydrogenase or oxidase or reductase, it shouldn't be surprising that they need electron carriers such as FAD or, later on you'll see, NAD as part of their coenzyme crew. Because riboflavin is found in such a wide range of different foods, it's extremely rare to just be deficient purely in riboflavin. If you were to have deficiencies in riboflavin, it would usually be due to the fact that you're deficient in other vitamins as well. Here are some conditions associated with riboflavin deficiency. As you can see, most of it revolves around the inflammation around the mouth area. Kyphosis and kyphitis are both inflammation and scaling and fissuring of your lips. Stomatitis is the inflammation of your mouth. Glossitis is the inflammation of your tongue. Dermatitis is more generalized inflammation and irritation of your skin. For test-taking purposes, I wouldn't say that any of these conditions are very specific or unique to riboflavin deficiencies. You can see these in other vitamin deficiencies as well. But if you want, you can remember that the inflammation around the mouth area, coupled with the corneal vasculations in the eyes, that could be a way to remember riboflavin deficiencies. And that is it. That is riboflavin. Hope you found the video helpful. If you liked the video, give the video a like. And if you really like the video, consider subscribing. It will really help the channel grow, and I can make more videos for you guys. If you have any questions or comments or any topic requests, remember, you can always put it down in the comment section down below.